Hi, it's Tales Vids. In this video I'm going to demonstrate a feature in iOS 9 called Split View. Now, Split View, it's only compatible with iPads. You can't use it on iPhones. And also, as the slide overview needs more processing power and more RAM, because you've essentially got two apps running on the screen at the same time, there's only certain models of iPads that you can use this Split View feature on. And these iPads are the iPad Pro, the iPad Air 2, and the iPad Mini 4. Allows you to have two apps running on the screen at the same time, pretty much occupying 50-50 of your iPad screen. So you might be in Safari and you might want to jot some details down off of a website. So in that instance, you could have the Notes app running on the other half of the screen and you could be jotting the details down as you looking through that website. Another scenario you might come across is you might be on a website and you might need to log in, and if you've got a password program such as 1Password, you can have half the screen took up by the 1Password, and you can basically copy and paste details off of that into the login fields of that particular website. So what I'll do, I'll go on to Safari. Now, to activate slide overview, to activate split view, you first need to just slide over from the right hand side of the page. You roughly need to have your finger about halfway up the screen, but if you're not just high enough to activate the slide over, you'll get the little bold drag handle appearing telling you whereabouts you need to drag, so you just move your finger up there and that'll then bring up the last used app. Now, if you see on the right hand side, now we've got an app opened. Now this is called slide over because it's just slid over a little bit from the right, it isn't full split view yet. And if you notice at the top of that right hand side app that's come up, you can see a little white grab handle, and if you drag down on that, that'll bring up a list of recently opened apps, and you can just scroll up and down to pick from one of them apps. What we'll do, we'll just pick 1Password. Now, to put both apps into split view, you can see on the secondary app, which is on the right hand side, you'll see a little white grab tab on its left hand edge. If you drag it over, you'll see the screen will change and you'll have pretty much 50-50 of each of them apps on the screen. So what you could do now, if you needed to log into that particular website, you could just basically copy and paste details from this 1Password program or other similar app into the login fields of that particular website without having to use the fast app switcher to switch between the apps. You've now got them both on the screen at the same time. And you can also move the app a little bit further over to change how much of the view you're wanting. Now, to switch to the primary app, and the primary app is the one on the left hand side and the secondary app is the one on the right hand side. So to switch to full screen for the primary app, so in this example it's the left hand side app, which is Safari, you can see the little grab tab down the black line in the center of the screen. Now if I drag that over to the right over, you can see now that we've went full screen with the primary app. And to do the same, but this time on the secondary app, which is on the right hand side, we just drag the tab over to the left and that'll put the secondary app into full screen. So now I've demonstrated this 1Password app, you might have another scenario where you would like to go to a particular website and jot down some information. So in this example, I'll use the Notes app to jot down some details I'm wanting to jot down, but you could also use other similar apps. So what we've got, the iPad screen on split view now. So to change the secondary app, which is the one on the right, we just drag down the little tab at the top, the little grab tab, and you just choose which app you want. So now I can look through that website and just touch on the right hand side app, and I can basically type in the details I'm wanting to type in, and then you can just simply just touch on the left hand side and that'll put you back into the primary app, and then I can just touch on the right hand side to continue with my note taking or whatever app that I was on. Obviously everybody's got different scenarios, but this is just a couple of examples of what you can use a split view for. Now, if you're wanting to change your primary app, so this is the one that's on the left, I can just double tap the home button and choose from recently used apps. As you can see there now, I've got the news app opened on the left hand side where previously it was Safari. And also to switch to the secondary app, like I showed you earlier on, you can just drag down from the top. I think it would have been maybe a little bit easier as well if the left hand side app, the primary app, had the little same drag tab as well. Perhaps that might come in later versions, but with it being Apple, you never know. But I think that would have been a welcome addition if they'd done that. So as you can see there, the recently used apps that I've had open. As you can see, you can switch between the two. If you do have the iPad in portrait mode, you have slightly less than 50-50. I think it's 70% of the view is portioned out to the primary app and 30% is to the secondary app. But with the landscape view, you have pretty much 50-50 view. Well, I think that covers everything for this video. I hope you found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up. And also, if you subscribe to my YouTube channel, you'll receive emails when I upload any new videos. Well, thanks for watching. Goodbye.